When I was first asked to give this talk tonight, I didn't know what to think. Honestly, I was shocked. I remember the first question I asked was, will I be a photographer? Which allowed me to be more present, and feel different things. So that leads me to my second word, feelings. All the feelings I will get during Mass at Founders. The feelings I get when I hear that and the lovely Founders Chapel Choir sing. Especially when they sing Ocean, so that song is fire. The feelings I get when I hear the Major Homily from Monsignor Dan or Father Martin. How I felt the first time I saw Father Gino walk up and down the aisles. How I felt after Mass, seeing everyone, all the hugs, and sharing stories about our week. So I would leave Mass feeling inspired, hopeful, at peace. And most importantly, I would leave Mass feeling loved. And when I think of love, I think of family. My family couldn't be here today, won't ever make it. I still love them, and that's okay, because as I look around the room, they're friends that have become like family to me. My young family, Ryan, other people that I can talk to about anything, and they'll genuinely listen. They'll be able to see through all the ups and downs, all the laughs. And I'm blessed to have people that I can talk to about all these things. I mean, just this semester, I welcomed a whole herd of people into my family. I mean, each of you show me God's love in tangible ways. You all know how much you all mean to me, so I'm just stopping at that. I can talk about you guys for days. And thank you so much. Now, the last word that starts with the letter F is probably one of the main reasons now, as I leave USD, that will connect me to Founders. Now, there's at least one person in this room that believes that F stands for Father Mike. Father Mike, I won't forget about you this time. I remember I was giving a talk at Spirituality Served about how I found my home at USD. And I mentioned different orgs, BUM. I was even going to mention Jerry, the guy who works at the SOP, for always greeting me and saying hi. But I forgot Father Mike, and he did not let that go. So, Father Mike, I love you. But for me, that word is faith. Believing in something greater than myself. Having faith that God is working all around me. Like right now, I know I should be studying, but I have faith that I will pass my final exam. Faith that my dad is looking down on me proudly as I give this talk. Having faith that our past will cross again, that God will allow us to reconnect, and there will be no awkward hugs. See, this faith is so important to me because I can take it anywhere. Wherever life takes me after graduation, I have faith that God will always be with me. Now, I can walk by faith and not just by sight. So one day when I start a family and have children, I can instill that faith into my children, and then their children's children, so I can start something beautiful in my family. Now, if anyone here had the same feelings I initially had when I started attending Mass, or this awkwardness, or feeling out of place, there are some truly, genuinely amazing people in this room that you can talk with. They will listen to whatever it is you have to say. More importantly, they will meet you where you are and walk with you on that faith journey. I know me and Alec had a lot of talks with different people. I can't see, it's kind of dark. So I'm sorry for anyone, but they will walk with you on that faith journey. And I know because I'm living proof. Founders and the people here changed my life so much. I never thought one of my biggest takeaways from UFD would be faith. So found the chapel,